Hey everybody. Well, guess what I'm gonna be doing right now? I am doing an impromptu CD review. I'm really excited about this CD that I got the other day in the mail. And I'm fixing to show y'all what it is. I'm at the mall parking lot. I just went to Panera for breakfast. Got me a free reward. I got me a free breakfast wrap. And this coffee drink. The coffee drink was not free. The wrap was. Oh, and as y'all can see, I got my hair refreshed. And this is no filter. This is the actual color. Red. I think I'm going to try a new color next time. I think I'm going to try pink next time. I've been wanting to try a different color. But the CD I got, and I'm really excited about this. This is Darius Rucker. And this is called Darius Rucker Ones. Wait, no. Darius Rucker. It's got 11 songs on it, and it's number one. It's volume one. It's got like all the hits on it. So hopefully this is good. I like Wagon Wheel and Beers and Sunshine. So I liked Hootie and the Blowfish back in the early 90s. So I'm really excited about this CD. You know, there's a lot of, you know, African American, country singers now, like Darius Rucker. I really like Jimmy Allen, Darius Rucker, Jimmy Allen, and Kane Brown. I like Kane Brown. Who else? I don't like that singer, I don't know. I can't get into her. Mickey Guyton. I don't. But yeah, those are. I don't think. Oh, Breland. Yeah, he did a song with Nelly, the rapper Nelly. So I'm gonna put this CD in and listen to it a little bit, because I'm excited about this CD. And let me see here. And if it cuts off, sorry about that. I'm not okay. So I'm gonna start it off. It's got, oh, it's got 10 songs on it. This is the CD right here. Okay, I'm gonna start it off. The cover. I left out in a cloud. And this doesn't even have a booklet. It's just a little swore I wasn't square. Coming back, said I had enough. Saw you in the rear view stand. I like me some good country. I'm wearing my Cole Swindell shirt today. And this is all the other CDs. I like this. This is called Don't Think I Don't. This is called It Won't Be Like This For Long. hope y'all like my new hair. I love it. Nice and red. And Eric did get my pool ready. My pool's ready, so I might swim in it today. It's kind of cloudy today, so we'll see. Ooh, I love it. I love it. I love this. Okay, let me. Okay. I'm just going to speed it up. I don't want this video to be too long. But yeah, back in the 90s, I loved me some Hootie and the Blowfish. I don't have all their CDs, but I have, I think, like two of them. Okay. I'm trying to speed it up. I want to get to the song that I know. Okay, I love this song. This is what I heard on TV. This is called Wagon Wheel. And down south to the land of the pines, I'm thumbing my way in North Carolina, staring up the road and praying to God. And this is what we're listening to. And there's a lady walking in the parking lot. This is where people come to walk. She's getting it, boy. Get it. Get it. I need to be walking. I need to be walking. I need to be drinking water, too. I tried a Starbucks drink the other day with some sugar-free vanilla. Nope. Nope, it tasted like crap. Sorry. I don't... Sugar-free on some things, I don't do it. Okay, this is... Alright, let me skip it. Okay, let me just... Let me go to Beers and Sunshine. This Beers and Sunshine song is really good. And I don't drink like this every day, guys, just so you know. When I do my mukbangs, everybody's like, how do you eat like that? I don't eat like that every day, you guys. Come on now. I love this song. I'm gonna have to get the rest of his CDs. I like this. Okay, guys, I'm gonna cut this short. Okay, so this CD is definitely a winner. Let me turn my battery off here. So, the other day when I was in church, this lady, her cell phone goes off in church, and she had to get up and answer it. That is so rude. Especially, and it was during prayer too. It was during prayer. I'm like, you had to answer that right during prayer. Like, come on. Like, it's, oh my gosh. That drives me so bonkers, you guys, when people answer their phone in church. I always have my phone ringer off in church. because I don't want it to go off. That would be so embarrassing. Like, when I'm at the doctor's office, I have it off, and I hate when I'm in the doctor's office and people are talking on their cell phone in the reception room, and they have it on speaker, so everybody in the reception room can hear it. And another thing, parents, come on now. Take your kids to the nursery. Don't let them scream and scream and scream in church when the preacher is preaching. I don't know how preachers do it and keep composure, like, and not, you know, and they just keep on preaching even though there's a kid screaming. A couple weeks ago, about 2 weeks ago, this kid was just screaming and screaming and screaming, and I was like, oh my gosh, take the kid out, man. Man, my mom, she used to take my butt out, man, and she would bust my butt if I was acting up in church. Oh yeah, she would. When I was a kid growing up in the 80s, man, you know, in Pennsylvania, we sat on the very front row, and if I was acting up, she didn't have no problems embarrassing me and dragging me out the front. And she would drag me out and she would spank me. We'd go outside at the front of the church, out right outside, and she'd have that ruler buddy, and she would spank the crap out of my butt, and it hurt too, buddy. She didn't give no hard, light paddlings. It hurt with that ruler. Whew. When I saw her bring that ruler out, that was some bad, bad, bad news. And she still has that ruler. It's so funny. She still has that ruler. It was last week. I came over here to the movie at the mall. I watched a movie. It was called The Watch. The Watcher. It was one of these stinking independent film movies. It wasn't Studio A24. It was a Studio IFC, which is another movie company. Don't ever watch an IFC movie. A24 and IFC. Look, if a movie says A24, Studio A24 at the beginning, you might as well walk out, because it's going to be stupid. I have not seen a good movie from Studio A24. So this movie I went to last week, The Watcher, I didn't even know what in the heck was going on. It was so stupid. It was weird. It was just weird. It wasn't that it was bad, it was just weird. But the thing about it, I was in there, and then these two older men were in there, and this old man with a walker was in there with another man. And the one man, not the one with the walker, but the other one, he kept getting on his cell phone and the bright light, and he just kept on doing this, and I was, you know, waiting for him to, you know, he would turn it off, and then he'd get back on it, and then guess what, it rang, and he answered it right in the middle of the movie. People do not have good cell phone etiquette. I really try to have good cell phone etiquette. Like, when I'm out to eat with some people, I'm not whipping out my phone. You know, I try to sit there and I try to, you know, talk and participate in the conversations at the dinner table. I'm not, you know, doing this. I'm not addicted to my cell phone like a lot of people. A lot of people are like, oh, I tried to text you. Well, you know what? I didn't check it. And another thing, I'm not into group textings. Do not put me on a group texting unless it's something important. Because I hate when my phone just keeps going off, 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 ring, 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 notification, notification. I don't do group texting, people. If you know me, and like you should, then you would know that. If I don't respond, that's why, because I don't do the group texting. Unless it's something like really major important, then like, it's like if I need to get in touch with you, I will let you know. Okay, I'll let you know if I need something, but I don't need all this chitter chatter and small talk and all that on the group texting. I don't need to know all that, okay? I'm drinking an iced Madagascar vanilla latte from Panera. So we need to talk about, I was waiting to talk about it. It's been a couple of weeks now. I didn't want to give no spoilers. So the American Idol finale. What in the living heck was that? 3 hours. 3 hours of nonsense. There's maybe like, and none of the duets of the, I mean, it was just nonsense. Like, 3 hours. Like, was that really necessary? 3 hours. And I knew the person that was going to win when it was down to like the final two. I knew who America was going to vote for. I knew between the two, I knew who America was going to pick. Out of all the good singers, that's who America picked. I wanted that one dude to win. That one that did the duet with Michael Bublé, the guy with the glasses, the one that had the vision problem. I thought he was good, better than the guy that won. 3 hours of that nonsense. I stayed up and watched 3 hours of nonsense. I'm telling you, American Idol, it's just gone down the toilet since they moved to ABC. Now, I liked Katy Perry singing, and I liked Luke Bryan. Lionel Richie. I like Lionel Richie, but when I loved it when it was on Fox. That was the good days when the show was actually worth watching. That was some nonsense. And then Carrie Underwood, she wasn't able to be on the show. She was supposed to be because of COVID or something. Which, I mean, I love me some Carrie Underwood. And I cannot wait till next year when I go to her concert. That is going to be awesome. I still haven't told Eric about New Kids on the Block. And I don't know how I'm going to tell him about that. Hopefully he'll be a good sport about it. He usually is a good sport about it. But another show I want to talk about. What did y'all think about Survivor finale? I mean, I never thought. I just didn't picture that Marianne girl would have won. I really wanted that Jonathan dude to win. Man, you know, it just comes, you know, it comes down to that fire challenge. That's the, you know, that old fire challenge will get you, man. You know, man, the fire challenge is what really messes it up for a lot of people. But I don't like how they didn't do a live, I don't like how they've been doing it. Like, the live audience, they didn't do, like, the last two times, and they didn't do, this time, they didn't do a America's Favorite Choice. They did last year, but it was that singer Sia funded it, so it was her money that she put up for it last year. But I just never would have, like, I didn't like that they did, like, the pizza party, you know, like after they announced the winner, they did the pizza party with the pizza and the celebration. That's stupid. That was a bunch of nonsense also. That was some nonsense also. I don't know. There's just nothing good to watch. Now, I'm telling you guys, I tried to watch an episode of Don't Forget the Lyrics, but I was kind of bored with that show, so I'm not going to watch that. I watched one episode of Don't Forget the Lyrics. I couldn't do that show. This is the rankings. This is the rankings of the shows that I could definitely. I love Beat Shazam. Beat Shazam, I could totally win some money on Beat Shazam. So it's Beat Shazam is number one. I could totally do it. And then number two, Name That Tune. I could do those two. So it would be Beat Shazam for number one, Name That Tune for number two. Don't Forget the Lyrics would be last. Because under pressure, I don't think I could do Name That Tune. And I can't sing worth a flip. So I wouldn't be able to do Name That Tune. But Beat Shazam, man, when I'm watching that show, I could name the songs in like the whole round. Like there's some where I could do a whole round and not make a mistake. I need to go on a game show like that. Well, guys, I'm going to get off of here. I just wanted to share that Darius Rucker CD with. Hold on, let me get it so y'all can see what it looks like. Darius Rucker. And, yeah. So, I hope you like this quick little video. I got some more video ideas coming up. Man, it is, like, really nice. That's why I decided to do a video right now, because it's not too hot right now. And I had breakfast. It's not even lunchtime yet. It's not even 10 o'clock. I don't even think it's 10 o'clock yet. I've been up since the crack of dawn. And when I say the crack of dawn, I mean the crack of dawn. So I'm kind of wired right now because I just drank that iced coffee. I need to go for a walk. I need to go put some shorts on and go walk. Because it is nice. I need to get my bike out. I got that bike and I hadn't even been using it because it's been hot. I don't know. They're still building in these apartments back here on the mall parking lot. That is the dumbest thing I've ever seen in my entire life. Anyway, guys, I'm going to get off of here. I hope you like this video. Hope you like my new hair color. I think I'm going to do pink next time. What do y'all think? Should I go for it? Eric says I should do purple, but I don't know. If I did purple, I might not do like solid purple. I might like mix it up with a different color. Like black and purple, or maybe like black, purple, and pink, or not just solid purple, you know? Maybe like black or something with it. I don't know. But I'm gonna get off of here. Hopefully y'all will watch this video and let me know what y'all think of my other stuff. So I'm gonna get off of here, and I hope y'all have a nice day, and I'm gonna get off of here.